Pardon me while I commune with the higher plane.
Please wait until my meditations are complete.
Please wait until my meditations are complete.
You are new, and you are welcome. I am Croatoa. I am not so new. Not here. We dream of a better world, not falling apart like ours. And when we find a dream that makes us forget this world, we dream that we do not have to wake up. Look to Jackson. He is the one who knows. But do not strain to see him here. Jackson is away. That hill is holy. It must be cleared. Jackson told us this. Some went to fight. I stayed with Ponga. Ponga does not fight. Ponga grows where it can. Ponga knows what is important. Ponga grows strong. I help Ponga grow stronger. Ponga understands me. I understand Ponga. That is all it needs to be. I do not know if this is a secret, but I have always used this shovel. It has seen much work and much dirt. If it helps, have it. But be careful not to cut yourself. It can make you sick. Blessings to you on your journey.
Something troubles you?
Another new member? What, are we offering a special? Ponga may have offered you wisdom, but it looks like it's still going to be a while before you really learn to accept it. Until then, you answer to me. I'm Woodrose, the tribe mother. Not so fast, grub. You haven't earned the right to go to the Transcendent Master's retreat. I'm Den Mother. I keep us safe and make sure everyone remembers to eat and sleep. It's more work than you might think. A lot of our members have transcended conscious thought. Someone's got to take care of them. Damn, you are wet behind the ears. Jackson leads us, and don't you forget, when he talks, you listen up and catch every word. Not that you'll be hearing much for now. He's off meditating. Jackson said he saw its destruction in a vision. There were some concerns, but when the leader says it's a mandate from beyond, you don't ask why. Are you kidding? Why wouldn't we? As much as we want to reject earthly desires, we still need to eat, right? It grows fast, fills you up, and you can make a lot of things with it. Anything it doesn't provide, we can get by trading it to outsiders. That shifty bastard Tobar's always looking to buy more from us. May you find your way.
Transcend.
Thank you. Be at peace. Thank you.
Looks like another newbie in the tribe, and still able to string together whole sentences. Ain't you the lucky one? You still remember your name? Math? How's your memory? When I came back, there were bits in my memory where all I could recall was a white light and a jumble of voices. Crazy, huh? But you're not drooling, so you're doing okay. The rest weren't so lucky when they got their heads cut open. You sure you're feeling okay in there? You might want to check your head for a scar. We all get them after going to that bog. You know, the last part of the ritual. After you pass out, they get a guy to bring you back, cut open your skull, and free your mind. As in, he rips out a bit of your brain. It's supposed to be the part that holds you back, but that doesn't always work out so good. Anyway, you look like a lively one, so welcome to the tribe. My name's Nadine. Off at his magical thinking cave, I guess. We're not allowed to know where it is. He says we're not enlightened enough to understand. I swear that sort of stuff pisses me off so much. I thought joining would be all drugs and magic, but it's just the same crap as everywhere else. Guess that's why I trailed Jackson to his stupid mystery cave. I only been here a week or so, but I'm about ready to ditch this bunch of dummies. I already stole all the punga I could ever need. Hey, if you still want to know where Jackson's hiding, I can help you out. No reason for me to give a damn about this place, you know? His cave's under the cathedral, but it's hard to find. Use this key to get in through a wrecked ship down at the sea cliffs to the east. You're a lucky one, and it probably didn't do any permanent damage. Scar'll heal up on its own and you'll be good as new. Of course, you'll still be missing a chunk of brain, but it looks like you didn't need that bit anyway. Now hold still and I'll see if I can help you look like your old self again. It's all a little fuzzy for me, but I've got a hunch. I'm gonna go do some snooping, see what I can figure out. Meet me by the riverboat in a day or so, and maybe I'll have something for you. Look, it's not that I don't want to go home or anything. I mean, I love my ma, even if she does make me want to claw my eyes out sometimes. It's just, I came out here to find a fortune, to make my mark, to be able to bring something with me when I do come back. If you see my mom again, let her know I'll be coming back, eventually, just not quite yet. Whoa, whoa, whoa! That was all Jackson's crazy idea. I knew better than to volunteer for that suicide mission. Last time I wandered too close to that mansion, some old ghoul sicked his dogs on me. Screw that. What is this, a date? You start making a move and it's stabbing time. What? There's not much to say. I ran off from home to see the world and find a fortune. And I'm doing it now, okay? Well, there's not much to say. I ran off from home to see the world and find a fortune. And I'm doing it now, okay? Yeah, enough gabbing. Let's move. Be at peace.
Escape to the mind. Something troubles you?
Be at peace.
You infiltrated those tribals yet? And you didn't go track him down and grill him for information? I'm not your daddy. Don't waste your time checking in. Go find him and figure out what he wants with this place, you moron! Back to business.
Oh, I knew you would return. Certainly, Madame Panada is quite handy with a wrench. Greetings once again, young traveler. Of course, I learned many tricks from my father. I knew that's why you came to me.
unburden your mind.
Shall recon.
impurities disrupting your perfect guidance.
Yes, fine. Go destroy the house and its impurities. Just stop that jammer and I'll be free of you morons once and for all.
Yes. All nations. Thank you, Master. Hello? You are a fellow seeker of the higher planes, perhaps. What brings you here? What splendid news! At last, the Holy Land is empty of his disruptive aura, and the astral plane is open to us all. Oh, but the Transcendent Master will want to hear of this, and as the returning champion, it is your right and honor to tell him yourself. After all, it is he who makes all true decisions about the spiritual growth of our tribe, including the decision to cleanse the mansion. It is very rare that others are permitted to commune with the Master. Many are too foolish to understand the great truths of his higher mind. But I sense in you a great potential. Perhaps you have what is needed to accept his teachings and grow from his wisdom. He manifests here, high on a ledge in the great sea caves. Well, seek him out, and all shall be revealed. We are a family of dreamers, a band of astral explorers, and a church of the mind. In time, we will be free of the horrors of the base physical world. We will play amongst the pure thoughts of the universe. I know it may seem that I am a brave shepherd to my flock, but the truth is far more humble. I am nothing more than the largest fish in our school, as we swim through the astral seas, exploring, learning, and becoming one. But we are not swimming aimlessly. No, we have a beacon. The Shining Mind speaks to me in my meditations, and guides us always. We take no pleasure in violence. Our goal was merely to remove the ghoul. His presence is an offense to the Transcendent Master's astral dominion. I cannot claim to understand the exact reasons that the mansion's resident caused such disruption, however. To understand fully, ask the Master. Yes, commune with him while I see to my tribe. There is much to be done. Yes, fellow seeker?
Desmond would be a nice plus. but I'm sure we can get around to that later. Desmond, that bag of bones and bile will pay dearly for his trespasses. Were it not for his interference, I would still have a body. Still, its absence is only owed by brilliance, so perhaps I owe it my thanks. An appreciation I'll show in the form of a quick and messy death. Of course I did, but that moron thought it was one of his adult visions. The real goal was to destroy the ghoul's jamming device. Honestly, those fools aren't worth the meat they're made of. A minion that can't follow directions is no use at all. Yes, away with you!
I knew it. I knew that little bastard was behind all this. After all these years, he's stuck his head out, and this is my chance to cut it off. Figuratively speaking, of course. Him. I should have known. My old rival, so close to his family home. Only he would be so stupid. He was once a man, Professor Calvert. The Calverts owned half of Maryland, back when there was a Maryland to own. Members of the Calvert family were influential all over the world. They practically owned a deed to the US government. In their best days, there were no less than 3 Calvert family senators, 7 members of the House, and 2 governors. They even had a top candidate for president, until that scandal with the dog forced them to drop out of the race. I was particularly proud of that one. Calvert is my old rival. Centuries we've played this game. I knew he'd be stupid enough to hide so close to his family home. It's not a matter of hate. It's a matter of destiny. He is my enemy, and I do not suffer any bastard who opposes me to live. I knew he was here. And it is my intent to find him and call down a righteous fucking hammer on his head. Figurative, I mean. His head. Of course I fucking want you to do something else. You don't expect me to trot around this mud hole myself, do you? You're goddamn right I am. Now let's get on with the work, shall we? So, those half-wits are getting messages from the professor, right? So he's off somewhere, broadcasting to him. But without those buggers to do things for him, he can't do much for himself. So, we cut off his ability to talk to him, and he'll need to try harder. Maybe then I can find the squishy little worm and finish him off for good. If I know the professor, he's using a high-frequency cognitive sign broadcast. I have the perfect device to jam up that little worm's talk box. All you need to do is take it to the highest point around and install it. Easy, right? Right. Attach it to the bottom car, then turn it on and spin the jammer to the top. No fucking problem. I'll watch from here and turn it on. Then we'll see where our little professor is. Now, go!
It is I, Professor Calvert. Don't bother looking around. I'm in your mind. But aren't you Desmond's faithful little employee? Coming to gum up my work, are we? Well, I have a better idea. How about instead of playing his game, you destroy that nasty little device? Deposit it in the nearby trash compactor and we will never have to worry about it again. I assure you that the gratitude of Professor Calvert is worth a great deal more than that of a washed-up old limey. And now it is time for Desmond to meet his end. He's made a fatal mistake. Return to Calvert Mansion. I have something there that I'd like you to see.
You bastard! Betray me, you fuck! You think you can betray me? You have one chance, exactly one chance to fucking redeem yourself in my eyes. We are going to go in there, and we are going to end this once and for fucking all, and you will help, or you will be my enemy. And you do not want to be my enemy. What? You betrayed me because I wasn't polite? Are you out of your fucking mind? Fine then. Would it make your little feel-bads all better if I said, please? Then pretty please, fucking help me rid the world of Professor Calvert. I I'm 250 years old, so I think I have a shiny thing or two that might interest your tiny brain. So, if it's riches and weapons and things that you want, I have more than enough to spare, and all you have to do is do what you do best. Follow orders and end Professor Calvert. I've waited a long time for this. Savor the moment, my friend. This is the end of an era. He's close by. Come. Let's go, before he has time to prepare. Thank you.
don't you just